Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope you're all doing good. So today's video, as you already have read the caption, it's all about a 7-day challenge that I'm gonna take using rosehip oil on my face. So rosehip oil is something that I use in my hair care routine, but I've never used it on my face. So I'm gonna take up this challenge, use rosehip oil 7 days back to back, and on the 8th day I'll be coming up with the review and I'll share all my pictures from day 1 to day 7 so that we can know whether this rosehip oil works or not. So let's get to the video. And I just woke up, like literally woke up 5 minutes before, and that's why I have those puffy eyes. But yeah, it's day 4 and I am so happy with my skin because it looks really, really, really good. I know there are still marks, but normally acne marks are difficult to go. It takes time. So keeping aside the acne marks, I think the complexion and the skin looks really, really, really different. I can say that because since few days my husband is asking me, what are you actually doing on your face, because it looks really different. Hence, I am so happy that it is showing a difference. So yeah, there are a few more days to go. Stay tuned for this and I'll show you all the pictures from day 1 to day 7 and the difference. So stay tuned. Hey guys, today is day 4 and I'm just gonna use my rosehip oil right now. So let's go. Like, for again, for the people who do not like to put oil on their face, they can just use a bit of few drops into your moisturizer and then sleep. Like after cleansing, toning, in your moisturizer you can just put a few drops of it and then use it on your face. But I was a bit skeptical about putting oil on my face at night because I knew I'll have breakouts, which I do have, like these very small 1 or 2 in the morning. But I guess it's working for me really nice. So it actually depends upon you. If you don't want to put, like, you just try once. If it doesn't happen, you can use this oil, like few drops of this in the moisturizer, and at night whilst before sleeping you can just put that moisturizer on your face and then sleep. But what I've seen from day 1, my skin is looking really good. And today is day 4 and I'm happy how my skin looks. So bye for today.
Hey guys, good morning, and today is day 5 and I'm here just to show you my face. So this is how my skin looks. As I said, in terms of complexion, it really looks good. But today I have not got any acne, thankfully. And if you're talking about the acne marks that normally you get, it doesn't remove all of those. And any which ways to remove those acne marks, it takes a long time. It doesn't disappear like overnight or in 2 days or in 7 days. It takes time. But in regards to the complexion, my complexion really looks good. And today is day 5, as I said, so I'll now come directly on day 7. My routine is gonna be the same. I'm gonna put rosehip oil at night before sleep, and in the morning it's the same like this. So now directly I'll be coming on day 7. Till then, bye guys, see you on day 7. Take care. Hey guys, welcome back, and today is day 8 and I'm gonna tell you my review about the 7 days challenge that I took up of using rosehip seed oil on my face. So to tell you about a summary of rosehip oil, basically rosehip oil is made up of rose bushes and it is mainly found in child. It is unlike those other rose oils which are made up of petals. This is actually made up of fruit and the seed of a rose plant. Rosehip oil is loaded with vitamins and fatty acids, which is actually really good for anti-aging, skin brightening, also has anti-inflammatory property. So before going to the review, I would like to tell everyone to do a patch test before trying it on your face. Do a patch test on your wrist or arms and let it sit for like 1 whole day and see if you have
any irritation or any allergy or something like that. And if you don't find anything, you can then start using it on your face. But if you have, then don't use this. So now if you ask me when should it be used, like whether it should be used in the AM or PM, then I would like personally prefer using it at night. But if you're not used to using oils on face, like I was not used to as well, but I tried it and as I said, it's really lightweight. It gets absorbed easily on your face. So I think I would personally use it at night, but if you're using it in the morning, you have to use it with a sunscreen. So yeah, that's how it has to be used. So let's jump to the reviews. So the 7 days that I did, I literally found out few good things about rosehip oil. And I'm sure that moving forward, I'll be using this rosehip oil in my routine. So the first thing that I saw was, now if you compare my pictures from day 1 to day 7, on day 1 I had removed my facial hair, and as I have told in my previous videos, I have sensitive skin. So after removing that facial hair, my skin had actually turned red and it was really itchy. So I started from that day and I tried putting the rosehip oil. So now I didn't try rosehip oil just like that. I mixed it with my moisturizer because I was not aware how it will, you know, affect my skin, as again I have a sensitive skin. So I tried mixing it with the moisturizer. The next day when I woke up, the redness was gone, the itchiness was gone. So I was just wondering, how is that possible? Then I've tried googling it out, and then I came to know that rosehip oil actually has vitamin E oil, which is actually an antioxidant, which known for its anti-inflammatory property, and hence it reduced my inflammation. So the second thing I found out was, it actually is a really good moisturizer for your skin. Now first day I tried, as I said, I tried it using with moisturizer. The second day I thought let me just try it using just the rosehip oil without the moisturizer, and it perfectly worked fine. So even if you don't have a moisturizer, finished your moisturizer, or you don't want to use a moisturizer, you can use rosehip oil as your moisturizer. Now the second experiment that I did was to use makeup on top of it. So that was the experiment that I did, and let me tell you, it worked so well. So if you want a dewy kind of a makeup, then this is for you. So you can use it as a primer, or you can use it as a serum. So normally, if you have seen those makeup videos where people use serum before, you know, starting on their makeup, guys, you should try this, because this works perfectly fine. Only if you like those dewy kind of a makeup. I was actually not a fan of dewy makeup, but when I tried this one, I actually loved it. So I think, and more often when I'm now going to the office, I do this dewy kind of a look because it looks really natural. So this one is non-greasy, hence it absorbs the oil so nicely that it also hydrates your skin. So you can use this as a serum or a primer. So that was the second thing that I found out. Now the third and the last thing, and this is something which I am blown away with, was the brightness of your skin. Now I swear by this product, because from day 1 to day 7 I can see a lot of difference. I'm not saying it will whiten your skin, I'm just saying it brightens your skin. It removes the dullness and it brightens your skin, and also it gives you that glowy kind of a look. I was so curious to know, how is that possible, like within even 7 days you can get that bright or glowy skin. What I found was, rosehip oil has vitamin A and vitamin C in it. Vitamin A increases the cell turnover, while vitamin C, as you all know, it boosts your overall radiance, and hence it gives you that glowy and brightened skin. So this is something that I really loved about rosehip oil. And so I was a bit curious whether it is just that I am dreaming, or whether it is true that it brightened my skin, because I couldn't believe my eyes, and hence I checked with my sister-in-law. She told me the same, that it actually brightens your skin. She uses the rosehip oil and it actually makes a difference. So when she also said, I was like, okay, so this works.
Those are the three things that I saw a difference in myself itself. So that was the reason that I took a 7-day challenge, that then you guys can connect with me, because I am really new to this rosehip oil. I use it on my for my hair care routine and everything, but I've never used it on my face, and I wanted to take up this challenge to see how it makes a difference. There is one more thing that they say, that it is also really good for anti-aging. Now I am really young to worry about that, hence if you guys are there, you can check it out and let me know in the comment section that if it works for you, if it works for anti-aging, because I am actually not aware of that. So that's it for today's video, guys. I hope you love this video, and do let me know on the comment section if you want to see any other videos or any other challenges that you want me to do. Thank you so much, guys, for watching. I love you so much, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye bye.